Hello everyone, in this video we're going to talk about how we're going to use a squeeze theorem to show that a certain sequence converges to a value. Okay, so suppose I give you something like this. Cn is equal to cosine n divided by n squared, and I'm asking you to determine whether it can actually converge or diverge. So as you know, we cannot use a related function to estimate convergence or divergence because, as we know, the cosine, even if we use the cosine x over x squared and then use the L'Hopital's rule, cosine will always fluctuate, right? It will always do this. So there's no way to figure out the limit. It looks like it will diverge. But we can associate the sequence Cn with something that stands on its boundaries. Okay, so other two sequences that are on two sides of the Cn. So we know that the squeeze theorem says that if we have the left boundary sequence, which is less than or equal to the sequence in question, which is less than or equal to another sequence on the upper boundary of it, and we know that if as limit approaches infinity, an is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity to the upper boundary sequence, and if both of their limits as the n approaches infinity are equal to zero, and since Cn, the sequence in question, is surrounded by them, it's in between, it's pushed by them, it cannot go outside of either of these sequences in its value as n approaches infinity, then we say that the limit as n approaches infinity of Cn, the sequence in question, must also be equal to zero. Okay, for all n greater than or equal to one. Okay, so let's use this. So you might say, but we have cosine n divided by n squared. Well, let's work with cosine n, okay? We know that cosine n has upper and lower values, right? The upper and lower boundaries for its values, right? We know that negative 1 is the least value for cosine n, so it's less than or equal to cosine n. And less than or equal to 1, right? The greatest value that the cosine can have, right? So think of this oscillation. Think of this as 1 for the cosine, and think of this as negative 1 for the cosine, right? Those are the boundary for the values that the cosine can have. Now notice that if we divide both side, all three sides of the inequality by n squared, it will still be true. Right? So negative 1 over n squared is less than or equal to cosine n over n squared is less than or equal to 1 over n squared. Now notice that if you take the limit as n approaches infinity of negative 1 over n squared, it will be 0. And the same thing will be true as n approaches infinity for 1 over n squared, the upper boundary for the cosine n over n squared, right? It will also be 0. So now using the squeeze theorem that we just talked about, for all n greater than or equal to 1, it must be true that the limit as n approaches infinity of cosine n over n squared will also be 0, okay? So cosine over n squared is going to be convergent to zero as n increases and goes infinitely. Okay, so this is how you would show using the squeeze theorem. So you're using sort of comparison sequences on both sides of the given sequence when you're asked to find or use the squeeze theorem. Please subscribe. I'll see you in my next videos. We're going to talk about more series. Thank you.